Scott from Super Nintendo XP's Game Room here, and welcome back to Brave Dungeon. I had tried out some Dark Witch Story combat. Woo! Woo! No. Luck-based stuff is not my kind of thing on camera.
Shiggle.
So, you must be curious as to how I know about a solo run.
I played through the original Brave Dungeon.
You know, the one that didn't have my current two party members. I guess I'll go to Windburn for now. But I must keep in mind not to battle the boss, otherwise I won't stand a chance. Well, that's a first. I can actually see his stats. Dark Witch knows that this particular version of Brave Dungeon actually creates a paradox. Because Klinzy and Neville were never in the original Brave Dungeon, and the original Brave Dungeon takes place between The Legend of Dark Witch 2 and 3. Too bad that 3 did not live up to 2, but it was developed by somebody else, so I'm not exactly surprised. They wanted to go with the source material, which was not a good move. I thought that the second one was the best in the series. I tried playing the crap out of the second character in the original, but it just did not work out. It's for the best that Klinzy got knocked out on that one. Question marks. Well, anybody who paid attention to the window open to the eShop file knows a little something. So each of these items basically is your special item that maximizes the potential of your character. I don't understand why you even bothered with that, but hey, what you gonna do? Alright, so I'm going back to Alverstone in order to defeat the boss on this floor. Fight! This guy's gonna be easy. I don't even know why I hesitated. Time to knock out some foes. The key to beating that particular foe was to keep him busy. Alright. Let's try the second floor. I probably don't stand a chance, but why do I care? I've already been beaten once, so... This is one of those battle musics that you really would like to hear in the background before fighting. Zone of Dawn. Man, in Legend of Dark Woods 3, that move is really effective at all times. Because you cannot see for shite. And don't be fooled by me using British terms. I'm in America. I just like to play that way. And other colors. Does that make me worldly? Yeah, hardly. Okay, let's see. the original Brave Dungeon, I questioned why on earth Klinzy was not a playable character. I mean, she's your typical mage. I did not understand why she wasn't on there. And I still don't, for that matter. I am surprised as crap that Neville's on, along with Klinzy. How curious. So I picked both of them to see just how differently they would play out, and then I'll play the characters I did not play in the original, just to spice them. It said that you get different endings depending upon who you beat the game. That did not happen, because I had beaten the game Palmer solo. Jump is plain useless. A Brave Dungeon where the script is flipped. What if some of these beastkin decide to take out their revenge on I? Or even better, what if they were simply seeking the power to keep their people free for good? And they had to fight famed heroes like Zizo and others. enough to tag exactly where the boss was. Oh dear. Well, I know for a fact that I do not have enough power to beat that boss. Woke up half an hour ago. Usually takes about an hour for my medicine to kick in, and that's when I start feeling normal. So I'm afraid it'll still be a little while, guys. No need to stop the video though. If I fight all of them, I should be able to level up just before the boss. I didn't see the gauge go up very much. Yeah, it's not looking too likely. But it's probably best I just fight him off anyway. I imagine that would have been annoying here. Clap, clap, clap every time. It was that silly girl who was inside the fish, anyway. crap, I could have ranked up, I think. Oh well. As much as I want to use Red Flame Phoenix, that's not a good idea right now. And not to mention... Oh, multiple revenge powers have been reached. Good shooting.
We'll be right back.
Knuckles is lying every time he says that, because he doesn't read it. Every time he says that, in Sonic Adventure 2, that whole thing does that. He doesn't realize it. It made him really funny, actually. Such a serious lie. Turned into so funny, so bad. Not to knock this guy out against that. He's too easy. Oh, what do you know? I'm just going to knock this one more guy out, grab the materials, and leave. Well, if things keep going this swimmingly, I may as well try and nab it all off. Who am I, Mario? Maybe.
Of course I am. I'll knock every one of them out. Not really. Not
seem to get stuck deciding what magic they want to learn next, though. I don't understand why, though. I mean, they get to learn it all in the end, so why worry about it? That's why it didn't take much time making my decision. I just picked what spell I thought I could use next, rather than the stats. To reveal as much map as I could around the top. Now it's time to spread around and fight. Oh, look at that static loving tool. Are those four hands? Yeah.
what I think this game could really use? A summoner! Neville should have been a summoner. Playing Brave Dungeon a lot is its music. I wouldn't mind having like the official soundtrack. Say, devs. I want to be able to change the order of my moves. I want Rock Bullet to be up at the top, and Blue Heart to be above drawing fire. Allowing your people to change the order of the moves would streamline things a lot. Oh, just memorize the position. Yeah, I know that. But I'm a long-time JRPG player. I should know what I'm saying. See what I mean? I did not want that right there. It got confusing as hell. Considering Neville and I have similar moves, I did not want to mess things up. And there I just did. One more fight and then it's a level up. Aw, man, are you joking? Well, I'll use the item refresh. I mean, reset. There we go. I should have used it with a little bit more discretion, but whatever. I don't normally use reset. Yeah. Wait, did I just get an accessory? 25% ring, yep. Switch the sleep guard with 25%. I have no need for the zero guard. up until two floors from now when it missed on me. Switch to auto heal with defense up. I'm good. Bada boom. Yeah, it's definitely worth fighting these foes right now. I'm getting a lot of XP. Up until I know any better, I'm thinking of Neville as my attack hound. Yeah, okay, I had a lot of good attack moves, but... You know what? I think I'll actually change it based on that. Is fastest. I think I actually have the best build possible for now.
No.
bad itself, but I just tried to double check whether there was any sort of glitch in the code. Take it and go.
Time to stop you cold! Hyper freeze!
Yeah, baby! Sure, I could use escape. So what? There's a little curiosity in the map here. Why is there an up symbol when it's technically going down? I mean, it says floor 1, floor 2, but technically you're going down. Okay? Just a thought, developers. You ought to swap the symbols and make it floor B 1. I mean ground floor. Floor B 1. Floor B 2. Or make it that you actually go upstairs. What does it matter? Here you go, miss. There's more for you, miss. Random nature is just, it is what it is. Ew. So I'm thinking that it's better yellow shade. I'm not a big proponent of autosave, but in this game it's a really good thing.
I could not go there yet without defeating at least two more floors apiece. Call me spoiler guy or whatever, but about the Medina second floor. The snowman there is extremely powerful for its level. More red chicken, huh? Alright, devs. I want a compilation of Legend of Dark Witch on Switch. With an increased aspect ratio. By that I mean, make the sprites the size they are now, on the screen. That'd be awesome. Hardly any more screen scrolling, just good old platforming goodness. I'm changing the battle display to the right because I can hardly see the left. My stand's blocking it. Wait, that does not include the order? Are you joking me? Alright, developers, that is a glitch. The whole interface, including the player order, should be there. Wherever the box is. Capiche? Sorry, viewers, I always try to... Knowing that good developers watch their players' videos, or at least hire somebody to do so, I always try to communicate via my videos at times. Contradictory as it is. Yeah, go ahead. Fuck my bones. You're good. Thank you.
I didn't miss anything.
Let's go. What a pity. Wonder if in this particular version, when you do face an area boss, some of their party members will come in as well as. Because I basically soloed it in the original, and that wasn't right. I mean, two of these party members were with her the whole freaking time.
Boom, chakalaka.
I'm doing well when that doesn't knock me out.
We'll be right back.
Palmer, the healer, is the one who's ending up surviving. Never mind. Ow! You couldn't tell me that I wasn't warned, because you'd be lying. Going to take a break. Be sure to like this video. If you want more, be sure to subscribe for more retro content. Plenty of retro content, cartridges, etc. And content like this that's a little bit more modern. This is Scott for Super Nintendo's Peace Gamer. You have a good one.